Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm really excited to share with you a brand new beta version of Nobe OmniScope. This release is packed with features we've been working on for quite a while, many of them requested directly by our long-time users. And there's more. Together with this beta, we are also releasing the first live pack features for beta testing. I'll cover those in a separate dedicated video because they deserve their own deep dive. But for now, let's walk through the new features in OmniScope itself. Let's start with something big for macOS users. Our OpenFX plugin now supports direct GPU image sharing. This means the signal is handed straight to OmniScope with zero latency and without expensive CPU to GPU copies. We've also reduced CPU and GPU usage dramatically, especially when monitoring heavy resolve timelines. And here's a key change. The input scaling option in the plugin now makes a much bigger performance difference than before. Moving on, let's talk about navigation inside scopes. You can now zoom and pan in the source viewer, the false color and the skin tone scopes. Just use the mouse wheel to zoom and hold space plus drag to pan around, just like Photoshop. Another exciting addition is SRT stream input support. Now you can connect to a live SRT feed, paste in the stream URL and instantly analyze remote video in OmniScope with low latency and secure transmission. This opens up new workflows for remote grading, live production and distributed teams. We've also reimagined Luma targets in the waveform scope. Now you can drag and drop them interactively, see numeric labels for precision, assign custom colors, and even adjust the thickness for visibility. This makes it much easier to control exposure and maintain consistency across different shots. And building on that, we now have global target sets. This is a really powerful way to manage different requirements across projects. For example, an advertisement might require a specific product color palette. You can save those as target set and recall them instantly. Or maybe you want to keep a consistent look for a sky shade, a skin tone or a single object under different lighting conditions. You can save that as a set as well. Switching between setups is now quick and effortless. For those of you working with multiple monitors, you'll be happy to hear that layouts are now saved and restored flawlessly. When you reopen the app, your workspace comes back exactly as you left it, no more rearranging. Another helpful addition is application window snapshots. Instead of just grabbing a frame, you can now capture the entire OmniScope window, complete with scopes and overlays. This is perfect for documentation, team reviews, or sharing client-facing snapshots. The color picker has also been upgraded. You can now choose multi-pixel averaging from 1x1 single pixel all the way up to a 9x9 grid. This gives you more stable results when working with noisy or compressed footage. On the audio side, the audiometer scope now supports a complete suite of standards: DB, DBFS, DBU, LUFS and VU. So, whether you're doing broadcast loudness compliance, mastering or general QC, you'll have the right scale available. And since many customers rely heavily on false color, we've added a color picker directly inside the false color scope. This is especially useful for those who don't use the preview scope in OmniScope because they already have a reference monitor. Now you can sample values directly inside false color, making exposure and skin tone checks faster and more accurate. Another workflow enhancement is support for PNG overlays with Alpha. You can load transparent overlays for save zones, frame guides, branding or broadcast graphics, and they'll blend cleanly over your signal. We've also added an option to lock the waveform scope to a fixed 16:9 aspect ratio. This matches the most common video formats and it also makes documentation easier. When you grab screenshots for QC or reports, the frame representation is always consistent. And finally, a simple but very practical addition, global brightness controls. You can now adjust the brightness of the whole UI on the fly, either with keyboard shortcuts or by mapping it to your Stream Deck. This makes it much easier to adapt when moving between bright and dark working environments. That's a wrap for the new OmniScope features in this beta. And remember, this is just part one. We also have live pack features running out in parallel, and I'll cover those in depth in the next video. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, you can grab the trial on our website if you'd like to test the new features yourselves. See you in the next one.